I can think of a lot worse things than spending 1 hour and 30 minutes admiring Jake Gyllenhaal's incredible acting skills. Hey guys, welcome back to Adlib Talk, and this is my review for The Guilty. But before we start this review, don't forget to leave a like on this video if you enjoy it, and please do consider subscribing, as those are two main ways you can help support my channel. Cheers, and let's get right into that review. So The Guilty is a crime thriller movie which recently released on Netflix. It is a remake of the 2018 Danish film of the same name. I have to be honest, I still have not watched that version of the movie, so I cannot compare and contrast the two movies in this review. This will be plainly The Guilty 2021 version on Netflix. The plot itself is quite basic. We've got Joe Baylor, an LAPD officer with tons of problems and personal issues, who is working at a 911 call center. He's working the night shift in this movie. Next morning, he knows he has to go to court for something that happened a few months ago on the job. As he goes through his usual day of receiving calls from people who have been robbed by prostitutes or drunk drivers who have crashed, he receives a particular phone call by a woman called Emily Lighton. Joe quickly works out that she has been abducted, and it is now a race against the clock to find out who has abducted her and where they are. The Guilty is a movie that depends a lot on its main star, Jake Gyllenhaal. Most of the supporting cast is pretty much only heard, never seen, as we see the whole movie basically through the lenses of a 911 call taker. This is a great concept, but that naturally means that Gyllenhaal really has to bring his A game, since without him the movie will quickly collapse. And thankfully, Gyllenhaal gives us probably his best performance since Nightcrawler. I have always loved movies that focus a lot on these kind of speaking roles without us, the viewers, seeing anything that is described. I think Gyllenhaal has the ability to carry movies, and he does indeed carry this particular movie. He brings out all the stress of a 911 call taker, the kind of stress that they must experience on pretty much a daily basis. As we see Joe do everything he can to solve this case, to be honest, some stuff which is illegal and some stuff which is very, very illegal, we start to get a better idea of who Joe is. I thought also that this element of the movie was one of the best things about it. We obviously start off knowing pretty much nothing about Joe, but through some pretty good writing, we slowly start to learn more about him, seeing his actions and seeing the way he responds to the ongoing crisis. We start to get to know our protagonist better and start to better understand what has caused the personal issues and problems he's facing, as well as the upcoming court case he has in the morning. Now, to be honest, Gyllenhaal's character Joe is not exactly a nice person. As I said, he has a lot of issues, both past and present, and he treats his job with a certain sense of impudence and arrogance. As we see his response to certain petty calls he receives, we can clearly see he is currently hating what he is doing. He is the kind of cop who kicks the door first and asks questions later. He thrives in action. Being behind the desk is not made for Joe. But that is where we find him throughout these 90 minutes. And Gyllenhaal takes full advantage of this, showcasing some incredible emotions as the stakes get higher and higher. He kind of sweats profusely and he sort of breathes from an inhaler whilst barely being able to speak. This is all showcased excellently with a number of terrific close-ups, showing all the beads of sweat on Gyllenhaal's forehead. He does a lot of work with his face, but his physical acting in this is just as good, as he paces up and down the call room, sometimes slamming his fist out of frustration due to the bureaucratic procedures in play to save someone's life. To add to the camera work is the excellent editing in play. Both Maz Makani and Jason Ballantyne have done a fantastic job in showcasing Gyllenhaal's excellent performance. And what about the man at the helm? Antoine Fuqua is the director of one of my all-time favorite movies, Training Day. Once more here, we have a movie focused around cops with some commentary about cops that unfortunately feels quite bland. The discourse about police violence is something very relevant to the times. Unfortunately, this movie has nothing fresh to add to that discourse, and that is a big pity, especially given the limited scope of this movie. Or perhaps Fuqua himself simply did not intend to do so, but still I feel like it is a big miss for a movie like this. Now, The Guilty is a kind of movie that will constantly have you on the edge of your seat, unable to take your eyes off Gyllenhaal's excellent performance and the tension that grows as the story develops. It is well written, it is well acted, and has some pretty good cinematography and editing. This was a great effort, and I highly recommend it if you're up for a good thriller. My overall rating for The Guilty is a 3.5 out of 5. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed that review. And if you did, don't forget to leave a like on this video and please do consider subscribing. Cheers, and I'll see you guys next time right here on Ad Lib Talk.